Salut, c'est Géraldine. Bienvenue sur Comme une Française TV, Sound French, Even to the French. Today we'll talk about food and vegetables. Food is a great start to explore French culture because it's at the heart of it. And the great secret to French food is great ingredients, for example, carrots again. If you want to pass as French, you need to know your vegetables. Which vegetable do we use in our day-to-day lives? How can you buy them at the market and pass for French? Which word and sentences can you use? And most of all, what dishes can you cook with vegetables in France to get something tasty? Let's dive in. Ready? Yeah! Vegetables in French are called les légumes, les légumes. Most of them are les légumes verts, greens, that we also call les légumes frais. It's a bit ambiguous because here green doesn't mean the color green, it means fresh. And les légumes verts is opposed to les légumes secs and les féculents. Les haricots verts, that I don't have today, sorry, are green beans. Les haricots verts. And we have une courgette as well, that I have here. That's une courgette, or a zucchini in English. Une courgette, like that. We also have another one. L'aubergine. Ooh, l'aubergine, the eggplant. L'aubergine. It was funny because when I was in England, I didn't know about that. And in a recipe one day, I saw eggplant and I had no idea what it was. That's l'aubergine for you. We also have another one that we just saw. Le poireau. We have several ones here. Les poireaux. And several poireaux make une botte de poireau. And you have the white, le blanc, et le vert, and usually you eat this part, le blanc de poireau. We also have carrots that we saw before. That's a lot of props today. Les carottes. So you have une botte de carottes, that's several carrots, and that's les fans that we call, like that. Les fans de carottes. You also have les fans de radis, for example. It's this long thing. Les fans and les carottes. In terms of green vegetables, you also have les petits pois, which are green peas. Les petits pois. Les petits pois. You can probably find any of these in a supermarket, but it's even better to get them at the market in France. Depending on your location, it might be a bit more difficult to find the other ones, such as une citrouille, a pumpkin, or une betterave, a beetroot. That these ones you can often find in a supermarket already cooked and ready to eat. Une betterave, they're purple. And un navet as well, that I have here today. That's un navet. And it's violet here, purple, violet et blanc. Violet et blanc, that's the usual navet that you can find in France. Some other groceries are sometimes classified as vegetables, such as un champignon, mushroom, such as le champignon de Paris, which is a very common one we have here, le champignon de Paris, which is very often not produced in France. We have un oignon that I have here. That's un oignon, this one is yellow, you have purple ones, you have white ones as well. Un oignon, you have le chou as well, a cabbage, un chou. You have l'ail as well, which is supposed to be very French. That's l'ail. So that's une tête d'ail, the whole thing. And une gousse is the tiny things inside. Okay, so une tête is made of several gousse. That's something you will find in recipes, for example. L'ail, l'ail. You also have la laitue, lettuce, la laitue, and also more generally called la salade that you can find at the market and at the supermarket as well. Other vegetables are not really des légumes verts. Some are what we call les légumes secs, dry vegetables. Les légumes secs. For example, les lentilles, for example, les lentilles du sud-ouest that we eat with le canard, les lentilles du sud-ouest. We also have les petits pois that we mentioned before, which is Actually, un légume sec, but most people see it as a green because it's green, but it's un légume sec. And you also have les lentilles corail, which are more and more popular here in France, les lentilles corail. Then some vegetables are also un féculent. Mainly, it's la pomme de terre, la pomme de terre. And I think you know what it is, but I brought you one from my house this morning. That's une patate, une pomme de terre. La patate is the kind of the slang for la pomme de terre, but it's very, very used. Une patate. And it's also a slang name for money. Des patates. That's a slang name for money, which is pretty fun when you look at a potato. Comment acheter des légumes au marché? How can you buy some vegetables at your local market in French? Comment acheter des légumes au marché? About this, I refer you to the earlier episode we made about the market. That would be very useful. You will find the link on the blog below the video. And also, if you already took one of my premium courses, I think you remember the lesson from Subtle French for Fitting In about the market. It was very, very fun to have the actors go through how it is to buy stuff at the market, such as meat, vegetables, and we had so much fun doing this lesson in this course. You can find vegetables that are labeled as bio. Bio, that's for organic in French. We say bio for biologique, biologique. Even better when it's local as well. We say de production locale or locale, produced locally. And if you can, try to find des légumes de saison, des légumes de saison. This is very important in France. It's vegetables that are appropriate for the season you're in. So it means that you're not buying tomatoes in winter, for example. Another interesting word about this is locavore. Locavore means trying to eat things that are produced locally. Locavore, vore means to eat. Some vegetables are bought by weight. For example, you can say, Bonjour, je voudrais 200 grammes de haricots, s'il vous plaît. Bonjour, je voudrais 200 grammes de haricots, s'il vous plaît. Hello, I would like 200 grams of beans, please. Look at the structure here. I say je voudrais. It's du conditionnel and not future because future would use no s. It would be je voudrais without s. Here it's je voudrais with an s, and that's a polite way to ask for things to buy in France. Some vegetables are better bought by number. For example, bonjour, je vais vous prendre 4 carottes, s'il vous plaît. Merci. Bonjour, je vais vous prendre 4 carottes, s'il vous plaît. Merci. Hello, I will have 4 carrots, please. Note here the structure je vais vous prendre. It's a very, very, very colloquial way to buy things at the market or at the supermarket as well, or anything that's food related, but not in a restaurant, okay? It's okay if you use je voudrais, it's okay if you use je vais vous prendre, both are fine. I know that sometimes students in my premium courses struggle with this structure, but that's fine. Just learn it and that's how we say it. Some vegetables are bought in une botte. For example, as we saw before with the carrots, une botte de carottes, une botte de carottes, but we also say une botte de radis or une botte de poireau. It's several vegetables bought together, usually tied up together. Une botte. And while we're here, don't forget your greetings. Bonjour, but also how to thank people. S'il vous plaît, please, and merci. This is very, very important. And while you're buying vegetables at the market, why not get some cheese as well? Cuisiner des légumes. Cuisiner des légumes, how to cook your vegetables. Here I'm not going to give you recipes on how to do it, but mostly words that are related to cooking the vegetables. If you're not eating meat, you are un végétarien or une végétarienne. Végétarien or végétarienne. And if you're not eating any animal product, you're a vegan. And in French we say vegan. Vegan. Yes, that's roughly the same word, vegan. And you can say, je ne mange aucun produit d'origine animale. Je ne mange aucun produit d'origine animale. Why is it important to know that if you're a vegan? Because not every French person knows what it is to be a vegan. En accompagnement is how we serve vegetables as a side dish. En accompagnement. Okay, and it's en accompagnement de la viande ou en accompagnement du poisson, for example. En accompagnement as a side dish. If you're doing a pan of vegetables and you're just kind of cooking them quickly in dices, that's une poêlée de légumes. Une poêlée de légumes. It comes from the word pan in French. Une poêle. Une poêle. Also, we have un gratin. Un gratin, which is going to be vegetables put together with some cheese and put in the oven. If you want to make a salad, that's une salade de légumes. Une salade de légumes, and that's perfect for summer. And also, if you want to make a soup, we have exactly the same word in French. Une soupe. And you can try any traditional French dishes and make as many as you want yourself. Et toi, what is your favorite vegetable in French? Tell me in the comment section, I would love to hear from you. If you're watching this on YouTube, you will find a link below this video to the blog commeunefrancaise.com. On the site, I read all the comments and answer all the questions as well. Want more? I highly recommend you join my newsletter. Subscribe now and you will get my Everyday French Crash Course. It's a fantastic free 10-day mini course to sound French even to the French. It's super easy to join. Leave me your first name and your email and you will receive lesson one today. Best of all, it's free. Merci for watching Comme une Française TV, sound French even to the French. Allez! Salut!